Hi, my name is Dave. Today I'd like to talk about training on the balance system after a person has a total hip replacement. After a total hip replacement, patients might present with balance issues. They have limited movement in their involved limb due to fear and pain. Poor proprioception is another common impairment that can affect the total hip patient's balance. To help patients become more functional, we can improve movement through sensory motor activities. You can use the postural stability test and percent weight bearing mode on the balance system SD. You can see the patient's improvement by observing the on-screen tracing or by reviewing their values in the test report. Once our patient gains more freedom to move safely, we can progress them from small to large excursions, multi-plane movements, and from stable to unstable surfaces. To help regain proprioception and the involved limb, have the patient stand with eyes closed on a foam pad or by varying direction of movement. A patient who has undergone a total hip replacement experiences significant muscle weakness on the involved side from the surgery and general disuse of muscles. One of the first things we want to do is to regain symmetry. Utilize various training modes to increase motor activity and improve strength and endurance. The percent weight bearing and weight shift training modes on the balance system are recommended. As you progress to varying directional movements and changing surface stability, increasing activity time with various training modes can also help increase strength, endurance, and movement. Patients may experience decreased weight shifting and weight bearing. This can affect their gait. It's important to work on bilateral symmetry. Along with weight shifting and weight bearing modes, the motor control training can help achieve the goal of bilateral lower extremity symmetry and motor initiation.